Hello everybody, this is Gunnar speaking. This is a little video I made because some of you were wondering what the core prediction is. So I made a little extra, some extra slides about this, and I also wanted to explain a little bit more here on the video. So hopefully it will be more clear after this little video. So first, just let's understand what a prediction is. A prediction is simply a simulation of something that you haven't measured yet. So, for instance, if you have a model and you have fitted this model to some data for the time-dependent concentration of A. And in this model there is also B, but you do not yet have any data for B. Then doing a simulation of B and seeing, for instance, what the time dependency of B is, that would be a prediction. So a prediction is simply simulation of something you haven't yet measured. So now there is the problem in systems biology, and this has to do with the parameters. And now remember that the parameters are the things in the model that has values. So, for instance, the rate constants or the initial conditions or measurement parameters. And if you put different values of these parameters, you get different simulations. And since a prediction is just a simulation of something you haven't measured, you also get different predictions. So, therefore, because the parameters are not known but and uncertain, especially some parameters, then the predictions will typically also be very uncertain. So therefore, if you now look here at the concentration of B as a function of time for one parameter, so now this is the simulation of B for one parameter, then we simply do not know yet if we can say that this is the way that the model predicts, the concentration of B to behave, because it might be that for some other parameter something completely different happens. So if we just take some hypothetical scenario here and look at not only one simulation here, but at all other simulations. So this blue curve here is the simulation for one value of all these parameters, and here now we see other blue curves. So here we have the old blue curve, and all these other blue curves are simply simulations where we have put other values of these parameters, and then we have done simulations. And now we have not taken any values for these parameters, but we have taken all parameters that can describe the old data. So all parameters that can describe the old data, all acceptable parameters. And then we do simulations for all of those parameters. And then we see that that this original curve that we had here is representative of what happens in some aspects. So here in the end we see that the simulation that we had was representative of what happened. So independently of which of the parameters that we pick, we always get the same behavior in the end. So as long as we stick with acceptable parameters, we will always have the same behavior in the end here. So after like 70 or 80 seconds, maybe 90 seconds, then they all reach 2 basically. But in the beginning, we cannot say that the behavior is always the same, but it will depend on all these parameters, on all these other parameters. And since we don't know which of these parameters is the true, we cannot really say that this is a unique statement. So the original prediction that we had here in the beginning, it's not really a conclusion. It's not really something that we say anything strongly about. It's just a suggestion. It can be like this, but it can also be in some other way. And I don't really have a reason to believe that it's in this way. So therefore, we call it a suggestion or a beach statement, whereas the behavior here in the end then would be a well-defined prediction or a core prediction. So now we are ready to see what is a core prediction. A core prediction is simply a prediction that is a well-determined prediction. So it's a prediction that really has to be fulfilled if the model should describe all the other data that we have. And now this stands in contrast to a prediction that has not been established as well-determined. And if it's not established as well-determined, we just call it a suggestion or a beach statement. And yes, so let's just have a look at another situation. So here we are comparing not different parts of the same time series, but we are comparing different predictions. So here we have four different predictions. So we look what happens to the state XP1, XP2, XP4 and XP5. And apparently here we have measured XP3 earlier. So we have some data for that. So all of these are predictions. And we see that here there are different lines with different colors, and they correspond to simulations with a model with different acceptable parameters. And we have tried to find as many different acceptable parameters as possible. And we see here now that it's very different for X of P1 and X of P2, that if we take one of these simulations for X of P1, it's sort of representative. It's sort of determine the behavior with a small uncertainty. Whether if we pick an arbitrary prediction here with X of P2, it's not very representative of what will happen. So this would not be an example of a core prediction, but this would be a suggestion. And the same is then true for all these other here as well. But here we have a core prediction. So this is now a well-determined prediction, and hence a core prediction. And now, just in the end, a little repeat of the fact that if you haven't done an analysis, so as we had in the beginning when we only had one curve, then we simply don't know anything. And if we don't know what is well-determined and what is not well-determined, then all aspects are just suggestions, because we haven't proven yet that some of these are core predictions. So before you know anything, you just have one simulation, then the simulation is just a suggestion. So that's it for my little summary of what a core prediction is.